Hi, in this video I will show you how to build a hard driveless network with a server running Ubuntu. Here I have prepared a computer with Ubuntu server operating system installed. Besides, I have a laptop running Windows operating system. This laptop is also used as a client when finished. From my Windows computer, I connect to the Ubuntu server using SSH. To build a hard driveless server, there are 9 steps in all. Let's take the steps together. First, you set up a static IP address for the Ubuntu server. If your server was set up with a static IP address during the installation process, you can skip this step. You define the network interface. You set up a static IP address in case the computer has multiple network interfaces or you install it on a virtual machine. You open the file to set up a static IP address and do the same. You set the IP address to match your intranet IP address range. In this example, I set the server IP address as 192.168.1.2. Next, you set up the network face and set up the DNS address. After the setup is complete, apply the change to set up the static IP address to be completed. Because in the next step we install DHCP server on Ubuntu operating system, so you stop and disable the default DNS service. Having completed setting up the IP address, next, you create a folder called ZBoot and 2 subfolders are config and firmware. This directory will store the boot configuration files for the client. The next step, you download and build files, will transfer to the client computers on boot over the network. You install the necessary packages to build the boot files. After downloading the necessary tools, you navigate to the SRC folder. Here you create a file called bootconfig.ipxe. You enter the lines as above and update the IP address of the Ubuntu server. This file will be embedded in the startup files in the next step. Next, you embed the bootconfig.ipxe file in the ipxe.pxe and ipxe.efi boot files. To create 2 files, ipxe.pxe and file ipxe.efi, will take a few minutes, so please wait patiently. Alternatively, you can create an additional file on d-only.kpxe if your client computer won't start. After getting the 2 files you want, copy and paste them to the firmware folder created in the previous step. Each client computer needs to be assigned an IP address, so you set up a DHCP server for the Ubuntu server. Also, the server will transfer the boot file ipxe.pxe or ipxe.efi to the client computer, so you install TFTP server for the server. You rename the default config file and create a new config file with lines like above. Here you configure the DHCP server, the TFTP root directory, and configure the files that will be transferred to the client computer when boot. You update the address range that will be provided to the client computer, then set the gateway address, DNS address, TFTP root directory is pxe boot. If the client computer uses BIOS, the file to be transferred is .exe.pxe, and if the client computer uses UEFI, the file .exe.efi will be transferred. Don't forget to select the correct network interface you want to set up. You restart the service for the settings to be applied. Next, you create storage blocks to store Windows 10 image files. I will create a storage block first to store the Windows 10 image of the first client computer. You enter the lines as above, you can change the IQN if you want. Next, I create a folder called Disks to store the client computer's operating system image files. Then I create a file with size 18GB, you can create a larger file if you want. Note that the file name must match the block configuration in the previous step. The Windows 10 image file I prepared is about 15 gigabytes. Don't forget to restart the service for the settings to be completed. Here is the information about the block you just created, like size, IQN and LUN. We have reached the final steps of the video, so the server is almost finished. You create a new file named bootdisks in the config folder. You enter the lines as above and update your Ubuntu server IP address. Next, you create a boot file for each client computer. The name of the boot file depends on the MAC address of the client computer. I will take the MAC address of this Windows computer to name the file because I will be using the laptop as a client without a hard drive. Note that the file name has no uppercase characters. Then you enter the lines as above and update the Ubuntu server IP address. Here you can use other block storage servers as NAS devices in your local network. Next, you update the IQN configured in the previous step. With the first client, you no longer need to enter any more configuration commands. Here you download the Windows 10 operating system image file using torrent clients with the link above. So that you don't have to wait long, I have preloaded this file and unzipped it. After I got the Windows 10 image file, I mounted it on my Windows PC. Next, you connect to the block storage created on the Ubuntu server. You discover them by Ubuntu server IP address. After discovering the storage block, you connect to it. Now on your computer will appear two more hard drives. You use cloning software between the two hard drives. After about 10 minutes, the Windows 10 image file has been uploaded to your Ubuntu server. If you have more client computers, repeat the steps above. It's time to check the results after the preparation period. You connect the client computer to the local network by wire and set up the computer to boot over the network. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you want to know how to create a server like this on Windows operating system, then leave a comment. As you can see, the client computer has been successfully booted over the network and it runs Windows 10 operating system.